You know, we went out to see him about 10 days ago in Chicago at the transition headquarters, this very Spartan, bare bones place. And, you know, every time I've ever interviewed him, it's like he's had just come back from a 2-week holiday in the Caribbean. He's relaxed, he's cool, he's collected. I mean, you know, we saw him on the day that the numbers were announced that more Americans had lost their jobs in this past quarter than any time since the 1970s. So he's in the middle of this, you know, financial meltdown. And he, you know, he just was focused. He reckoned with everything that we said. He, you know, unlike a lot of politicians, he listens to your question and he tries to answer it. And I think what he also tried to do, because knowing that this is more than just a daily story, this is a global issue that reaches more people at one time than any other print product ever, he wanted to talk globally about what are the problems facing the United States, what are the problems facing the planet. And he talked about, as he said, let me tell you what keeps me up at night. Although it looks like he's getting sleep.
Okay, lay those out, because clearly he spoke to the economy,
right.
He spoke to Afghanistan, Pakistan, he spoke to climate control, and he spoke to nuclear proliferation.
Yes, in fact, Charlie, those were exactly the things that he laid out. I mean, I think he's basically saying when it comes to ranking those, you know, like Roosevelt said about himself, I have to be Dr. Fix the economy. I mean, I think he sees that as absolutely job number one, and that it has a multiplier effect on everything else. Because if that fails, everything else goes down a few notches.
And if that's strengthened, everything else is strengthened.
Absolutely. And I think, you know, one of the reasons that he made such a bold and strong choice for Secretary of State is to basically say, hey, I've got a lot of problems at home to deal with. I need somebody very strong to be representing America abroad. So the economy was really what he was talking about. He did lay out those other issues. He talked about Pakistan, Afghanistan, talked about nuclear proliferation. But even the energy issue is really about the economy, too, because, you know, his devout belief that green products and making products that help the environment can actually help the economy, too. And that's the way, that's the future way for American workers.
Yeah, I mean, he even is thinking long term. I think he said here that, you know, in your interview, that he looks at it as a 10-year process, engaging climate control and making the United States much more energy efficient. It's not a journey of two steps. It's a journey of many steps over a 10-year period.
Right. And I think he's, you know, he's looking for a course correction. I mean, I think he sees this as a pivotal moment in American history. And, you know, danger also equals opportunity. And I think he sees opportunity to reset some of the things going on in America to put us on a different trajectory, a different course. And so I think he is thinking long term, and I think he's thinking historically. I mean, you know, it's interesting to be elected president and think, how am I going to be looked at 10, 20, 30 years from now? But I think he is making that calculation.
Join us online at charlierose.com.